Okay, let me quickly give you an example of how an acceptance test is written. It is called as GWT. It's like given, when, then. So given is your precondition, when would be your steps, and then would be your expected output. So any project who is following ATDD methodology can write test cases in this particular format. Okay, so this is a typical example of a test case in Cucumber. It looks like, given I register for a webinar on TechGate and I receive a webinar link. Okay, so this is my precondition. So to begin this particular seminar, I have to register for a webinar on TechGate and I have to receive that webinar link. Okay, when I click on the webinar link, so this is a step that a user has to perform. Then I should be directed on the TechGate site and I should see Join Expert Speak button. So this is my expected outcome. So a test case is written in a very simple plain English language with the terminologies used of those products that you are developing. And this is where we say that this particular test case can be written even by the BA. So the requirements can directly come from BAs as well. Okay. And these are nothing but your acceptance criteria, and this is how even the customers can verify whether you have built the right thing. So when a customer wants to run this particular test case, he understands what exactly he is running. Okay, I'll just show you a live example of a GWT, how it is written. So it's just a demo application of Redbus. So if you can see this, this is a Java IDE that is being used. So when you use Selenium, as we all know, it supports multiple languages, and currently what we have used in our projects is Java. So this is an IDE, Eclipse, and this is a particular typical feature file. If you see this, if you see this, there is something called as @ Redbus sit availability, or @ Cucumber demo, @ 1.0, @ high. So these are various tags by which you can actually tag your feature file. So in the same manner as I mentioned, you can actually tag some of your test cases or some of your scenarios as @ smoke test. And when you want to run just the smoke test, so the core driver will tell that you have to run just the smoke test, and all the feature files which have @ smoke tag would get executed. So this is a simple feature that is being explained. In order to know availability of the bus seats to travel on Redbus online ticket agent in India, as a user, I want to check the availability of bus seats to travel in India from online bus ticket agent. These are different features of Cucumber JVM where I have written a background. Probably I can explain you this in detail. Background is nothing but a particular step which you think will get repeated throughout this particular feature file. So every scenario that I am writing, this particular step would be common for all the test cases that I'll write in this particular feature file. And hence I can actually separate that particular step and put them in background. So I need not write that every time that I am writing a test case. The other thing is scenario outline. So this is a particular scenario where the application should display availability of seats for one-way journey if bus services are available. Here we have written a GWT called as given I enter the cities from source point to destination point. These two are nothing but your parameters, and you can actually fill in the values here. If you see source point and destination point, you have been mentioned values as Mumbai, Hyderabad. So these are the two values that would go into this parameter, and you can actually mention n number of parameters out here, and as much as parameters that you have or as much as values that you have for those parameters, let us say Mumbai Hyderabad, I can say give Mumbai Bangalore. So as many times the values are mentioned, this test case would get executed that many times, each time taking a different value for that parameter. And I enter date of journey for next day. When I search the buses, then the availability should be displayed for one way if buses are available. Now this is a particular test case. Here, for example, I can give a tag out here saying that @smoke. So this particular test case will get executed every time smoke test runs. Okay. Similarly, I can prioritize my test cases. So for here, this prioritization of 1.0 could be a release. The priority is high. So when I say when this thing is high, this is applied to the entire feature file. Else you can also do is you can actually tag every test case with a priority so that when you say high, all the test cases which are marked as high can be run. So this is a very simple test case file, and if you see the amount of time that I will require to write a test case drastically reduces. If I'm writing a test case in an Excel, I have so many columns to fill in basically with my data, with my preconditions. So all these things can be clubbed as a single test cases with different sets of data. Also, you can see that since I have written something which is very common, it again reduces my time of writing test cases. And not only this, when I write a fixture file, for example, when I am saying writing a fixture file is nothing but writing a code basically against this particular return statement. So that also I'll have to write just once, and anyone who is using this particular common step can reuse that functionality. So as I mentioned that initially to build library files you may take a little time, but eventually once your library files are written, you are just reusing those aspects. So this is how a feature file looks like. This is exactly how the code is written. So I'll just go back. Okay, let us say I'll just show you, given I logged in as a user in online Redbus services, let us see the code written for it.
हेलो ज्योति, वी कैन नॉट हियर यू। देयर इज सम इशू विद योर वॉइस।
हेलो, हेलो, आई थिंक वी गॉट डिसकनेक्टेड प्रॉब्ली समटाइम्स व्हेन आई वाज एक्चुअली एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कोड फॉर द गिवन. सो लेट अस जस्ट बिगिन फ्रॉम हियर. सो एज आई मेंशन्ड, so this is a particular line which is there in your feature file against which you are writing the code, and this is a particular function called as login redbus. This login redbus has a Selenium code under it, and as you can see that there is absolutely no object that is embedded in this particular code, and this actually enables us to start writing the automation code right well in advance before any screen is delivered to you. So you need to just, if you see this, this is the object that needs to be recognized on the screen. So this is tbx user underscore username. So this is a text box underscore username. So these are certain things that probably we have followed in our code, and this is what needs to be pulled at the time when your automation code is running. So you can just define an object either later in the stage when you get the screen, or if you have a developer sitting next to you, you can actually speak to him as to get those object identifiers, or else if you have a standard practice in place of defining each and every object with an ID, then probably you can even start using the same. So this is exactly how the code is written against a GWT. So let me take you through the benefits that are there as a part of following ATDD as well as doing in-sprint automation within the sprint itself. Is one biggest advantage is you have a high percentage of test cases that are automated within the sprint. So this itself leads to the second benefit that is being written, is increased testing efficiency. So now that you have so much of your test cases automated, you can actually execute them very fast, and this will also enable the testers to do additional ad hoc testing if required during the sprint as well as during your hardening or system test phases. Then biggest advantage again is you actually capture defects right in the beginning. So you have your test suite that is automated, and you can run them whenever you want. So every sprint the test cases are getting executed, the regression suite is getting executed. So any impact of the latest features on any of the regressed areas can be identified immediately, and those defects can be captured early in the development phases itself. You are doing real continuous integration. So by enabling automation right in the sprint one, you are ready to run the automation script on any build that comes. So if you can actually implement real continuous integration only because you have automated such a huge test cases, and you should be able to run them every time. Motivated workforce. So the ability to run automation tests early basically will increase the confidence of the testers for a particular product, and definitely will increase the peace of mind and transparency in the team. So this is definitely going to motivate the entire workforce. And the framework that has been explained is a reusable framework. So this, as I mentioned, can be used across, it can be used independent of the tool and even independent of the application. So this is how it can be actually used. I'll just take you through a case study very quickly, where this particular